Hello everyone, this is your chemistry teacher. Today we will learn how to name an organic compound. So there are some rules you have to know to name an organic compound. We are talking about the IUPAC names. Okay, so in doing the IUPAC names of different organic compounds, we have to know some basic rules. So let's discuss the rules one by one. So the first rule is saying that you have to number the carbon atoms following the longest carbon chain in the compound. So in the compound you might have found a lot of carbon chains, so you have to number that carbon chain which contains maximum number of carbon atoms. Okay, so that is called the longest carbon chain. So we have to number the longest carbon chain in that compound. Okay, so in the longest carbon chain, probably you could find functional groups that contains a carbon atom, like aldehyde group, CHO. It contains carbon atom, so this carbon atom will be numbered. Ketone, CO, it contains carbon atom, so this carbon atom will be numbered. COOH, that is acid functional group, carboxylic acid functional group, it also contains carbon atom, so this carbon atom will be numbered. COOR, it is the ester group, it contains carbon atom, so this carbon atom will be numbered. Amide group, CONH2, amide group, this contains group contains carbon atom, that is also numbered. Cyano group, that contains carbon atom, that is also numbered. Okay, so we have to number the carbon atoms following the longest carbon chain present in that compound. Clear? Now the next rule is very important, which provides the priority order of different functional groups present in a compound. So in a compound, more than one functional group could be present. Okay, then you have to decide which functional group will get the priority. This is because once you decide the functional group which will get the priority, which will get the more priority, then you have to start the numbering from that side. Okay, suppose there are two functional groups, COOH and COOR, present in a compound. So you have to start the numbering of the carbon atoms from that side which will contain the COOH. If COOH is present in the left side, then you have to start the numbering from the left side, and if it presents in right side, then you have to start the numbering from right side. Okay, so the priority order of different functional groups are given as COOH first, then COOR, ester group, then COCl, it is called acid chloride group, then CONH2, it is called acid amide group, CN, cyano group, aldehyde, then ketone, then hydroxyl, then triple bond, and then double bonds. So this is the priority order of different functional groups if present in a compound. Now the next rule is that the third rule is the most important rule, because this rule will govern you how to name the compound exactly. Okay, so to name the compound, you could have found more than one functional group in the compound. Where there is a functional group, where there is a side chain atom or side chain group, okay, where there is a another functional group. So first of all, you have to highlight the second priority group. First of all, your first duty is to highlight the position of the second priority group. Okay, then you have to highlight the side chain atom or groups. Side chain atom or groups means, suppose there is an alkyl group, or alkyl group means methyl or ethyl or propyl or butyl. So these are all called alkyl groups. So if there is an alkyl group in the side chain, not in the main chain, in the side position, in a branch position, so then this group is called alkyl group. It is the side chain group, okay, or side chain atom. It could be a halogen atom, chlorine or bromine or iodine. So either the halogen atoms or the alkyl groups, they can act as side chain groups or atoms. The first you have to highlight the position of the second priority group, second priority functional group. Then you have to highlight the side chain atom or side chain group if it is present in a compound. Then you have to highlight the carbon chain, how many carbon atoms are there. Okay, then you have to highlight the first priority group. So your first duty is to highlight the position of second priority group, then side chain atom, then the position of side chain atom or the side chain group, then the main carbon chain, then the position of the first priority group. Okay, so third point is very important. Now the fourth point is for the side chain atom or groups. Okay, the priority order will be in the alphabetical order. Okay, suppose there are two side chain groups, methyl and ethyl. So since ethyl starts from the alphabet E, that is that will be more that will have a more priority than methyl, that is actually starting from M. E is in the alphabet alphabetical series, E is present first, so ethyl will be named first. Position of the ethyl group will be named first, and then the position of the methyl group. Okay, so positions of the side chain atoms or groups will be occurred in an alphabetical way. Now the fifth point is to designate the number of functional groups. Suppose there are two methyl groups or two chlorine atoms or two aldehyde groups are present. So in that case, what are the prefixes you have to use? If there are two functional groups or side chain groups or side chain atom, then di. If it is three, then tri. If it is four, then tetra. Five for penta, six hexa, and hepta for seven functional groups. These prefixes are used. Clear? Now the next point is, in case of benzene or aromatic compound, when you are naming an aromatic compound or benzene, then you number the carbon atom from top carbon atom, that means carbon number 1 to carbon number 6. Okay, there is no other way, only carbon number 1 to carbon number 6, from top to rest carbon atoms. Okay, one by one consecutively. Now the last point is, whenever you are highlighting the position of a functional group or of a position of a side chain atom, you have to put a number, suppose 3 methyl. So whenever you are using the number 3, so you have to put a hyphen before 3 and after 3. Okay, so if you are writing 4 methyl, then you have to write hyphen 4 hyphen methyl. So whenever you are using the, you are writing the number before the number and after the number, you must have to use the hyphen. Clear? Now here we will learn about the prefix and suffixes that are used to used for different functional groups present in a compound. So here two types of things we will observe, two types of prefix or suffix we will observe. The first one that is here named as suffix name. These are the suffix names that are used for different functional groups, where these functional groups act as principal functional groups in naming the compounds. Now another column is made that is named as substituent for the same functional groups. Substituent. Now under the substituent column, all the functional groups will be replaced by some name, where these names are used for these functional groups when the functional groups or these groups act as a substituent. That means they will not act as a principal functional groups for that compound, they will act as a substituent. Okay, substituent means they will be present in the side chain. Okay, they will be present in the side chain, not in the main compound. They will be present in the side chain. So how we will know that these functional groups are actually in a side chain, not in a main functional groups. If these functional groups are involved in numbering, or if these functional groups are involved in carbon chain numbering, then obviously they are the main functional groups. And if these functional groups are not numbered, they are just present in a side chain, then they act as a substituent. Okay, so let's see what are the suffixes that are used for different functional groups. When they are used as a principal functional groups, and when they are used as substituent in different compounds. Now, for first of all, for carboxylic acid. For carboxylic acid, the suffix is OIC acid, oic acid. The suffix is oic acid. And when carboxylic acid group act as a substituent, then it is called carboxy group, carboxyl group or carboxy group. Now, in case of ester, RCOOR, this is the formation of, this is the general formula of ester. RC double bond O bond OR. R is the alkyl group. R is the alkyl group. Okay. So, it is called ester. So, in case of ester, the suffix used is oate. O-A-T-E. Oate. And when it is present as substituent, it is the name alkoxy alkane or alkoxy carbene or alkoxy alkane is used. Okay. In case of amide, RC double bond O NH2, it is called amide function group. The suffix is amide, but when it acts as a substituent, the term is amido. RCN, it is called nitrile group. CN, nitrile group. Okay, so cyanide group, it is called nitrile group. When for nitrile group, the suffix is nitrile, and when it is present as substituent, the term is cyano. For aldehyde, suffix is L, that for substituent it is formyl. For ketone, C double bond O, R C double bond O R, it is a ketone compound. So ketone compound means suffix is one, O-N-E, but when it acts as substituent it is oxo. Okay, ketone means oxo when acts as substituent. Alcohol, suffix name ol, substituent name hydroxy. Amine or amine, RNH2, amine compounds. Okay, functional group is amine, bond NH2, but I am writing the functional group in the form of compound RNH2, where R is the functional group, R is the alkyl group. So this is amine compound. So in case of amine compound, suffix is amine, and when it acts as substituent, the term is amino. Okay, alkene compound. Okay, this is the alkene compound, double bond alkene compound. Suffix is in, okay, in substituent it is termed as alkene. Triple bond compound, that means alkyne. Suffix is yne, ine, yne, and as substituent the term is alkyne, that is used. R group, that are called alkane group. Okay, when they generally act as alkyl group, so they generally act as substituent, and this is the alkyl group. Alkyl group is the term that is used for R, that is, that generally acts as substituent, that's why this is more popular, alkyl group. Now ether, these are ether compound, bond O bond, ether, R O R, ether. Okay, so generally ether compounds will be present as substituent, and the term alkoxy alkane will be used for ether compound. Now alkyl halide, RX, alkyl halide. The R group is called alkyl group, and this is halide halogen. So alkyl halide. So in case of alkyl halide, that means halogen atom. The halogen atom generally act as side chain atom or substituent, and the suffix that is used or the term that is used is called halo. Okay. If it is fluorine, then fluoro. If it is chlorine, then chloro. Okay, hello. Clear? Now, for different carbon atoms, how many carbon atoms are present, you have to look on in a compound. Okay, so according to that, there are some prefixes that are used. If your compound contains one carbon atom, then the prefix must be meth. If two carbon atoms, eth, 3, prop, 4, bute, 5, pent, 6 carbon atoms, that means hex will be used, 7, hept, 8, oct, 9, non, 10 डेक, 11 अनडेक, 12 डोडेक, 13 ट्राइडेक, 14 टेट्राडेक, 15 पेंटाडेक, 16 हेक्साडेक, 17 हेप्टाडेक, 18 ऑक्टाडेक, 19 मोनाडेक एंड 20 आइकोस. ओके, सो दीज आर द प्रीफिक्सेस दैट आर यूज्ड फॉर कंपाउंड्स कंटेनिंग डिफरेंट नंबर ऑफ कार्बन एटम्स. क्लियर? नाउ वी विल टॉक अबाउट सम एल्काइल ग्रुप्स. ओके, एल्काइल ग्रुप्स. Alkyl groups are generally formed when one hydrogen will be lost from a compound. Then alkyl groups is formed. So alkyl group has the origin alkane. Okay. Suppose CH4 is called methane. So if you eliminate one hydrogen, then it will be turning into CH3 bond. Then CH3 group is called methyl. Okay. So similarly, there are some alkyl groups. Which you have to know what are the terms that are used for these alkyl groups, like CH3CH3 bond. Okay, so this is the total alkyl group. This, so how many carbon atom? 3 carbon atom. So propyl, it must be propyl, but here one methyl group in the entire propyl functional, in the entire propyl group, one CH3 unit is in the side chain. So whenever you will find one or more CH3 unit in the side chain, the term iso will come into action. So 3 carbon atoms, propyl, it should be propyl, but one carbon atom, one part is in the side chain, so isopropyl. Clear? Here same, here 4 carbon atoms, so it should be butyl. Okay, but the thing is, the one carbon atom chain or one CH3 unit is in the side chain. Okay, so whenever it is in the side chain, then it should be isobutyl. But since this side chain CH3 unit is in the extreme positions, is in the terminal positions, so it is not termed as isobutyl, it is termed as secondary butyl. Okay, clear? You might have confused, might have been confused, but you think very clearly that whenever the one CH3 unit is present as a side chain and it is present in the middle of the chain, then the isoterm will come. So, but this CH3 unit is not present in the middle of the chain. It is present in the terminal position. Okay, it is present in the terminal position. So, for this CH3 unit, the entire functional group will be termed as secondary butyl group. So, 4 carbon butyl. CH3 unit is in the terminal position, secondary butyl. Now here you see, here also 4 carbon atoms, so it should be butyl, but here the CH3 unit is present right in the middle of the 2 carbon atoms, right in the middle of the 2 carbon atoms. So it is called isobutyl. Okay. Now this group, how many carbon atoms? 1, 2, 3, 4. 4 carbon atoms containing alkyl, containing group, arrangement is like that. Okay. This entire functional group is called tertiary butyl group. 1, 2, 3, 4 butyl. So tertiary butyl groups. This is the structure of tertiary butyl group. Okay, clear? So this entire functional isopropyl group, you can term this, you can designate as in this way. Here also secondary butyl group, you can designate as in this way. Okay. Here this tertiary butyl group you can designate as this way. Okay, so this refers to carbon atom. This is methyl, this is another methyl, this is another methyl. Methyl, methyl, methyl. Okay. Similarly, isobutyl group you can term it as this. CH2 bond. Clear? Okay, so these are the different prefix suffixes used for different functional groups, when they are acting as a main functional group and when they are acting as a substituent. Okay. Now let's take few examples of organic compounds and how, and then we will practice how to name those compounds. The first compound is this CH3CH double bond CH bond CH2CH double bond CH2. So here you see the double bonds, two double bonds are present and no other functional groups are present in this compound. Since these two double bonds are present right in the right side, right? In the right side they are present, right? They are towards this right side, this double bond and this double bond, they are towards this right side, correct? So you have to start the numbering from the right side. So this is carbon number 1, this is 2, this is 3, this is 4, this is 5, this is 6. Now, what is the position of these two double bonded functional groups? Position are carbon number 1, then carbon number 4. Because you are counting the number of carbon atoms from right to left. So you will find the double bond in carbon number 1, then in carbon number 4, right? So first of all we have to locate the double bonds. So 1 4, okay, 1 4, then two double bonds are there, so di in, and then the main carbon chain 1 2 3 4 5 6 carbon atoms, so hexane. So you can say you can name this compound as 1 4 diene hexane, or if you arrange the words to sound it in a more plaintive way, then you can term it as 1,4-hexadiene, 1,4-hexadiene, or you can term it as 1,4-diene-hexane, hexane 1,4-diene, or 1,4-hexadiene, or 1,4-diene-hexane, all are same, clear? Now let's move on to the next compound, CH triple bond CA, bond CH double bond CA, bond CH double bond CH, 2. Okay, so here you see two types of functional groups are present. One is double bond, another is triple bond. So according to the priority order, triple bond will be a more priority group than double bond. That means alkyne greater than alkene. So you have to start the numbering from right from this left side. Okay, so this is carbon number 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. So 6 carbon atoms are there. Okay, 6 carbon atoms are there. So this is a wrong, this is a wrong name that has been given here. It will be hex. Okay, 6 carbon atom, so hex. What is the position? Then according to the law, you have to highlight the position of the second priority group. So that means ene, that means alkene are the second priority group. What are the positions? 1 2 3 is the position, 4 5 5 is the position. So 3 and 5 are the positions of the double bond. So hex 3 5 diene, then the main functional group alkyne. So the position of the main functional group alkyne is carbon number 1. So 1 ine. The first you have termed the second priority group 3,5-diene, then the carbon chain hex, and then the main functional group ine, that means alkyne. So what is the position? 1. So 1 ine. So you can term this you can write this compound as 3,5-diene-pent-1-ine. Okay, 3,5-diene-pent-1-ine. Okay, so whenever you will find triple bond and double bond, since all the triple bond and double bonds are right in the straight chain, so you can first you name the longest carbon chain, then you highlight the positions. So that's why I have written here hex. Okay, it will be hex, huh? That is a mistake. It will be hex. So hex 3,5-diene-1-ine. So you can write it as 3,5-diene-hex-1-ine. Both are correct, but it's more this hex 3,5-diene-1-ine. It is sounding more in a good way. You can say that this is sounding in a good way. That's why I have written this in this way. So you can write it as 3,5-diene-hex-1-ine. Okay. Now let's move on to the next compound. That is this. Okay. So here you see double bond and triple bonds are there. So since you know that triple bond will get the priority first, so you have to start the numbering from the right side. Carbon number 1 2 3 4 5. So 5 carbon atoms, so pent, then what is the second priority group, what is the position 1, 2, 3. 3 is the position of the in, so pent 3 in, and what is the position of first priority group 1, so 1 in, pent 3 in, 1 in, or you can write it as 3 penting 1 in, both are correct. You can write it as pent, then second priority group 3 in, because the double bond has the position carbon number, has in the carbon number 3, 1, 2, 3, correct? And alkyne has the position in carbon number 1, so pent 3 in 1 ion. Okay, now let's move on to the next compound, CH3 CH2 CH2 CH double bond CH2. So first of all, you have to know that we have already discussed longest carbon chain. So if I start the we have to start the numbering from the right side, because double bond is in the right side, correct? If I start the numbering from here, then I can go through this path also, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. I can go through this path also, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. I can go for this path also, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. So all three paths are actually equivalent path. So you can take any one of them. So I am going straight. So 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. Okay. So what is the formula? The formula is, first you have to highlight the side chain. You have to highlight the side chain first, then the main function. Okay. The first, we have to highlight the side chain. Side chain means two methyl groups are there. What are the position? In carbon number 5. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. Okay. So, two methyls are there. So, dimethyl. So, both the two methyls are connected in the carbon number 5. So, 5, 5, dimethyl. 5, 5 dimethyl. Okay, then how many carbon atoms? 6 carbon atoms, so hex. Then what is the position of the alkene group? Carbon number 1, so 5 5 dimethyl hexene, or you can write it as 5 5 dimethyl 1 hexene, or you can write it as 5 5 dimethyl hex 1 ene. Both are, all these three are correct. Okay, now let's move on to the next one. So it is quite complicated, you can say. Here lot of carbon atoms are there, but don't be so confused. You just follow the rules. So if I go through the straight way, then 6 carbon atoms I will find. If I go through this way, then 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 6 carbon atoms are there. If I go from this way, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, then we will find 7 carbon atoms. Now the thing is, here there is a mistake, because I have started counting the carbon atoms in this way, but the counting of carbon atoms will be from left to right, not from right to left, because here you see the triple bond is there in the left side. Okay, triple bond is there in the left side, so you put the numbers 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6 in this way, then you go for the nomenclature of this compound. Okay, so you have to start the numbering right from the back side, right from the left side, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. Okay, because the triple bond is in the left side, so you have to from left to right, not from right to left. Now another problem is that you might think that if I go through this path, I'll find 7 carbon atoms. That's okay, but since the carbon atoms here, there is a triple bond, so obviously you have to give a importance to this triple bond, because it is one of the functional group. That's why I am taking this path. Okay. So I am leaving it. I will discuss this compound later on. Okay. Now let's move on to the next one. Here you can see that it is a cyclic compound. In this cyclic compound, here you can see that there is a double bond, and there are two methyl groups. These are the two methyl groups, and there is a methyl group here. Now, since it is butene, 4 carbon atoms are there, and it is cyclic compound, so cyclobutane will be the name of the main part of this total compound, cyclobutane. There is alkene group, so cyclobutene. Okay, alkene group is there, so cyclobutene. Now, what are the positions of the of these side chain methyl groups? The positions are, you have to start the numbering from this side, 1, 2, 3, 4. Okay, so 1, 4, 4. These two methyl groups are in the carbon number 4. So 1, 4, 4. 1, 4, 4. How many methyl groups? 3 methyl groups. So trimethyl. Okay, 1, 4, 4 trimethyl cyclobutene. 1, 4, 4 trimethyl. 3 methyl groups are there. So trimethyl and it is cyclobutene. Okay. Now let's move on to the next one. Here you see, this is the compound OH CH2 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 C double bond OH. That means it is the functional group CHO. This is aldehyde group, correct? And there is the alcohol group. So who will get the priority? Obviously aldehyde group will get the priority, and the aldehyde group contains a carbon atom, so this carbon atom must be numbered. So we have to start the numbering from the right side. So carbon number 1 2 3 4. Okay, so second priority group we have to highlight first. So 4, and it is not a main functional group. It is present as a side chain, correct? It is present as a side chain, so it is present as a substituent. So whenever OH is a substituent, we have to use the term hydroxy. So 4 hydroxy, there are 4 carbon atoms, so bute, and aldehyde group is in the carbon number 1, so bute 1L or butanel, or 4 hydroxy butanel. Next one is OHCH2CH CH3 CH2 CHO. So here also two functional groups are there. So first highlight the second priority group. So here also again 1 2 3 4, so 4 hydroxy, then the side chain 3 methyl, how many carbon atoms? 4 carbon atoms, so bute 1L or butanel. 4 hydroxy, 3 methyl butanel. Here the compound is CH3CO CH2CH2OH. So here you see there is a ketone functional group. CO is ketone functional group. So and CO is getting the priority here over the OH group, correct? So OH group is a substituent here. So what is the position of the OH group? 1, 2, 3, 4. 4 hydroxy. So 4 hydroxy, 4 carbon atoms, so bute. And what is the position of this ketone group? Carbon number 2. So bute-2-one or 2-butanone. Bute-2-one or 2-butanone are same thing. So you can write this compound as 4-hydroxy-bute-2-one or 4-hydroxy-2-butanone. Now let's move on to the next one. Here you see OH-CH2-CH2-C-double-bond-O-CH2-CH2-OH. Okay. So here you see the three functional groups are there. So obviously we have to start. This ketone group will get the priority over here. So you can start the numbering either from the left side or from the right side, because the overall compound is a symmetrical compound. Here you see the same part is there in the right side and in the left side as well. CH2CH2OH CH2CH2OH. So it doesn't matter from which side you are starting the numbering. So I am starting the numbering from the left to right. So 1 2 3 4 5. So what are the position of the second priority group? Carbon number 1 and carbon number 5. So 1,5 dihydroxy. How many carbon atoms? 5 carbon atoms. So pent. And this ketone is in the 3 position, carbon number 3. So pent 3-one. Or you can write it as 3-pentanone. 1,5 dihydroxy, 3-pentanone. Clear? Now let's move on to the next compounds. The first one is, next one is CH2 double bond CH, bond CH2 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 OH. So here you can find, you could see that there are two functional groups. One is alkene, another is alcohol. So obviously alcohol will get the priority over this alkene. So you have to start the numbering from the right side. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. These are the 5 carbon atoms. So first highlight the, but here this OH group acts as a main functional group, so it is no longer be termed as hydroxyl, it will be termed as all, okay, main function group. So first you highlight the second priority group, that means this alkene. So 4 in, the position is 4, so 4 in pent 1 all, okay, or you can write it as pent 4 in 1 all, okay, pent 4 in 1 all, both are correct, 4 in pent 1 all or pent 4 in 1 all, okay. So let's move on to the next one, CH2 double bond CH, CH2 CH2 CH3, it's very easy. You can see only one function group alkene is there, so we have to start the numbering from the left side. So carbon number 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 5 carbon atoms, so pent. What is the position of the double bond? Carbon number 1, so pent 1 in. Okay, now let's move on to the next one, CH3C, triple bond C, CH2, NH2. Okay, so NH2 is, will get the priority over this triple bond. So you have to start the numbering from this carbon atom, 1, 2, 3, 4, so bute. Then second priority group 2-ine, okay, then the first priority group 1-amine, NH2 is amine group, butte 2-ine 1-amine, okay. Now let's move on to the next one, CH3C triple bond C, CH2CH3, very easy, 5 carbon atoms are there because you have to start the numbering from the left side because this triple bond is present towards the left side of the entire carbon chain. In the entire carbon chain, this triple bond is present towards the left side, so you have to start the numbering from left side. So 5 carbon atom pent, what is the position of the functional group? Ine 2, so pent 2 ine. Okay, so these are the examples of few examples of organic compounds, how to name those compounds. Okay, and question 1 mark or 2 mark questions can come in your exam. Write the IUPAC name of this compound. Though you can expect, you cannot expect this question, write the name of the compound in this year, because IUPAC nomenclature is present in first chapter of organic chemistry, that has already been deleted by the board. But the thing is, if you don't know how to name the compound, then there could be a problem, because the questions will come by mentioning the IUPAC names of the compounds. Question could come by mentioning the IUPAC name of the compound. That it could come in this way, that what happens when pent 2-ine reacts with HCl or reacts with acid. Okay, so if you don't know what is pent 2-ine, then you would never find the answer. So you have to know the IUPAC names, how to name a compound by IUPAC nomenclature. Okay, so these are the few examples. You will get to know more examples by studying the book over the, and also in the internet you will find more examples. So watch out for those things and try to practice. This is all about this class. Thank you.